In 2018, Siraj Bakaleke, the former police commander for Kampala Metropolitan South, vanished from the country after the DPP instituted charges of abuse of office, conspiracy to defraud, kidnapping and abducting Korean nationals, and obtaining money by false pretense. After several months of fruitless hunting for him, the DPP dropped the charges against him.
He was briefly detained and then eventually given a police bond, which is answering. So we expect the file to go to the DPP today, and then we shall be guided by the legal opinion of the DPP, because there was a file of obtaining money by false pretense involving him, allegedly between him and some Koreans.
After over 5 years of being in hiding, Bakaleke surrendered himself to the authorities, as police spokesperson Fred Enanga explained. He was granted police bond and will face charges of deserting the Uganda police force.
Desertion is a criminal offense. When you desert from the force, it is after several days, 21 days, you're declared a deserter, and after that process, you become wanted. So for all these years, he was on our wanted list for desertion.
Bakaleke was one of former IGP Kale Kaihura's right-hand men and was implicated in the fleecing of 1.4 billion shillings from South Korean investors in a shady deal. He has been on the run since Kaihura was dropped as the IGP. Meanwhile, police have warned MPs Alan Sewanyana of Makindye West and Kawempe Northeast Muhammad Sejirinya against plans of holding illegal processions in the city center.
These acts of lawlessness and impunity are not encouraged, and the experience we've had with these illegal processions is they have a potential of massively disrupting the other, massively disrupting the rights of other citizens, like through the disruption of the flow of traffic, breach of peace, looting of shops.
Police have also explained why the new express penal scheme operations against environment polluters were halted. This follows NEMA's move to suspend the enforcement of the requirement for all vehicles to have dustbins or pay 6 million shillings in default.
Because with the guidance of the Inspector General of Police, it was noted that there were certain gaps in the legal framework that needed to be sorted out by NEMA before we start enforcing.
From the Kampala Metropolitan Police, police are hunting for suspects behind the alleged kidnap of Dr. Hamza Mbalire, attached to Kibuli Muslim Hospital. It is reported that Dr. Mbalire was kidnapped last week, and later on, a strange call asked for a ransom of 2 million shillings from his family, which was initiated by the wife, Madina Mbalire.
And all the times he's robbed of his belongings and money taken from the relatives. So we are calling upon the relatives to remain calm, not to give in to the kidnapper's demands as we investigate this matter.
And from the Ministry of Internal Affairs, Ugandans abroad who are still in possession of the machine-readable passports and are willing to return home have been advised to reach out to the various embassies or consulates to issue them an emergency travel certificate to allow them travel back home.
They will not return on this passport now, but that they will get a document known as emergency travel document at the embassy, given to them free of charge.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.